Thank you for joining us to our eChurch family, MFM family, and our friends around the world. We love you. God bless you.
Now, you know, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. And I know, Pastor, they are already glad because they are tuning into this service. God bless you.
Bless you. Welcome back to Mountaintop Family and our eChurch family from around the world. So glad to be back with you once again. Dr. House and I are so thankful for you that went along with us through our time of Oak Give Thanks. I pray, as it was for us, it was a great and awesome and spirit-lifting time of prayer and consecration and fasting and seeking the Lord and just getting directions. I know you were blessed, you that were able to do this with us. We thank you for trusting us as your spiritual leaders as we keep going forward. We pray this becomes more of a lifestyle to you as you use some of these attributes as you begin to grow in the kingdom of God. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Pray with me real quickly. Father, we bless you now for the word that's about to go forth. I pray that it would transcend the pages of this book and even from this tablet, go into the homes and hearts of your people, speak life and liberty and hope to all of us in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Well, I'm excited and we're really just built up spiritually and just glad for the time of fasting and what God is going to be doing and the open heaven. The Lord spoke to me during the time of consecration. He says, I'm putting you, Clinton, under an open heaven. He showed me the picture of Dr. House pouring a picture of water. And I was saying, Lord, why isn't my blessing coming? He says, well, your cup is in the wrong place. So move your cup over and get it up under the spigot where the blessings are flowing. And right now, Mountaintop Church family, eChurch family, we are under an open heaven. Give God some praise, put some high fives, some hearts in the chat, and thank God for the confirmation of the prophetic word. We are living now under an open heaven. If you have your Bibles this morning, come with me to a familiar passage of scriptures to most of us. It's in the book of Numbers, the 23rd chapter. I'm going to read this out of the New King James Version, verse 19 down to verse 26, and we'll get into our lesson. A lesson, let me give it to you up front. Trusting a changeless God in a changing time. Let me say it again. Trusting a changeless God in changing times. Numbers 23 and verse 19. God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. He has said and he will do it. Or has he spoken and will he not make it good? Behold, I receive commandment to bless, and he has blessed and cannot reverse it. He has not observed iniquity in Jacob, nor has he seen wickedness in Israel. The Lord is his God is with him as a shout of praise of a king among them. God bringeth them out of Egypt, and he has strengthened like an old wild ox. For there is no sorcery against Jacob, nor any divination against Israel. It now must be said that Jacob and Israel owe that God has done. Look at people raising like a lioness, and lifts itself up like a lion. It shall not lay down until it devours the prey and drinks the blood of the slain. Then Balak and Balaam neither curse them at all, nor bless them at all. For Balaam answered and said to Balak, did I not tell you, saying, all that the Lord spake, that must I do? And here is the reading of the word of the Lord. You see, the characters is Balaam and Balak that we are going to give attention to as we move through the lesson. As we see our present time, we are faced with a drastic change. The world is changing again. It appears that within these 10 months that we're facing now, that we are falling into a transition of a swift change. We even hear of some states shutting down, planning to shut down and dialing it back to somewhat slow the curve of this virus that is rising up again. You can almost feel the tension in the atmosphere and the uncertainty in the hearts of people wondering, will we have to go through what we went through again earlier this year? We used to sing a song in the church some years ago. We quote it and we speak to it every now and then. But today we hear the lyrics with a greater revelation. Times are filled with swift transitions. Not on earth unmoved can stand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hands. We have these words now and we hear them with a greater understanding. For surely time is filled with a swift transition. We speak of the immutable God, the changeless God is the immutable God. It means that God is so certain in being who he is. There is no changing in him at all. He is consistent at all times, no variations in him. Neither changing or shadow of turning in God. The very nature of God, the character, is absolute and he is without change. The essence of God's authority, his ability, is unchangeable. He is consistent. Malachi 3 and 6 says it like this, "For I am the Lord and I do not change," or "I do not turn back." He says also, "I have consumed you. I have consumed you. I could have consumed you, O sons of Jacob, but I didn't, because I'm God and I do not change." And he looks at the word in the text of Malachi 3 and 6. He says, therefore, he is no turning in him. Therefore, he is looking back at the scriptures that are prior to in that third chapter of Malachi, when he speaks to God's people of their disobedience and how he says, "I could have wiped you out or destroyed you, but because of my covenant, I did not take you out." I thank God for his covenant. I thank God for the New Testament and the covenant of God. He does not change. He cannot change. Based on his character, he does not change. There is no argument in him. He still is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. He's consistent. That's the God that we serve. God could have repented, and sometimes he does change his mind, but the nature of his character, he does not change. I know it sounds ambivalent in thought, but think about, he's consistent being God. If he has to come in and rebuke or correct or bring about judgment, it does not stop him from being God. His absoluteness is holiness. He's just and he's moral. He's divine in his obligations. He's good in his judgment. And all that follow him understand it is his mercy. By it, we are not consumed. Hath God all day long. He's always merciful, always loving, but he's also correcting. Mercy is love that when you fall way down low in life, mercy comes and picks you back up and bring you to your rightful place. God does not and cannot change what I'm trying to establish. The original understanding, the original plans of God and his purpose cannot alter or change. There is no shadow of turning with him. God does not repent of what he has promised. If he said it, he's going to do it. So it might surprise you and me in the text as we look at it, that God would choose a guy like Balaam, this wicked guy, obviously wicked. He's using him for an instrument to get his message to his people and to Balak about who God is. But this only shows us how God can take a Balaam, and use an unspiritual man and use him for his purpose. So the giftedness does not require spiritual maturity of holiness. If God wants to use you, he can use whoever he wants to use. That's God. If you don't believe it, turn back in the 22nd chapter and you see where God used a donkey to preach to his man. So God can use whoever he wants to use when he wants to use him. Our memory verses or the text that we're reading through this morning is related to the humanity of man. Balak. His name means waster. He is the king of Moab. Balaam is a devourer of people. Here he is a prophet for hire. The context in Balaam is writing to us in the 23rd chapter and sees through the 26 verses is the oracle speaking of God. Balaam and Balak are destructive forces coming up against God's people. Seems like they're not going to get through this hard place. But God is faithful. Balaam is the seer. Here he is now. He is hired by Moab, the Moabites, to come and curse God's people. God intervened because of Balaam's hard-headedness to go ahead and do what God told him not to do. The Lord says, you can go, but if you go, I'll put my words in your mouth in what you're supposed to say. He says here to Israel, and he's speaking also to the church. Whatever God says to Israel, he is saying also to the spiritual church, and that would be you and I. And God is speaking to us. God is speaking to a separated people, which was Israel and also is the church. God is keeping his covenant with Israel. He does not go back on one iota of his word. The same is true for spiritual Israel, which is the church. The Lord does not behold, the text says in verse 21 of there in Numbers 23 and verse 21, he says, the Lord does not behold iniquity in Jacob. Iniquity is wickedness or evil. Can you imagine God looking at his people and says, I don't see any wickedness or evil in you, nor do I see perverseness or laboring in Israel. We are the redeemed people of God that has the same testimony. Thank God he doesn't see us like man sees us. When God sees us, he sees the covering of the atoning work of Calvary through the blood of Jesus Christ. And when God speak it, he's going to bring it to pass in our life. The Lord is God. He is with us, the text says, like the shout of a king among them. The reference here in this context says that the shout of a king is a shout of praise. He's among the people, and the people have praise raising out of their mouths. Victory because of the battles that God has given them. Victory because of God has brought them to the place of overtaking their enemy. If you don't praise God for anything else before this year is over, you should praise God for the victory that you've already won. God is with his people, the text says. He's blessing them. He has complete victory over the enemies, giving them the victory over their enemies. God is different than man, totally different from the creation of human race altogether. God here has no need to repent. He is immutable. His word is unchangeable. No one can add to it. His word is integrable. Balaam and Balak are totally antithesis. They are different and opposite from God. But now men lacking in organization and dull of thinking. It is in them that God is speaking to them. His man is going to rise out of all of this. It is here God is seeing the supreme image of the differences of man and God. Balaam's words were indifferent before God. The prophet could not speak unless God put the words in his mouth. If anyone wants to come and give you a word of propheticness, ask them that they get it from the Lord. Because when God's put a word in the mouth of a man, a woman of God, that word should come to pass. The efficacy or the effects or the producing of God's word is that he brings about what he speaks. If he said it, he will make it good. It is in the 19th verse you see this, that if he spoke it, he will make it good. I just need you to start telling yourself, before this year is over, God's going to make it good. It may not look good right now, but he is going to make it good. The word he says here is never uttered void. God does not speak and things don't happen. When he begins to speak, things begin to happen. He produces things out of the power of his word. Isaiah says it in 55 and 11. He says, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me void, but it will accomplish what I have desired, or I have achieved the purpose for which I have sent it to do. That word goes out, and God has a purpose on that word. That word has been spoken in our lives. And we are speaking today about the unchangeable God, the changeless God in changing times. God doesn't lie. He can't lie. His character does not even encompass lies. His promises are sure and certain. God has promised his people Israel in the 21st verse. He says, I'm reigning over you as king. During this time, Israel did not have a king like other nations reigning over them. But still, they were very progressive in their walk because God was their king. God gave Israel victory and began to show this victory when they came up out of the Exodus. When they came out the Exodus, he says, listen, the struggle now is over. He gave them plenty for the journey that they were on. What is the distance and the distinction between them and us? It's pretty much the same. When God has brought us out of Egypt, and brought us into a place of a new land, always understanding that we can rely on the divine plan and favor of God. Hang with me, I'm just about there. It is here that he speaks in the 22nd chapter how the Moab is mentioned here. The Moabites, and Balaam is speaking of the Moabites. They said of Israel in the 22nd chapter, verse 4 and 5, that this domestic group, they looked at Israel and says, you're like a wild ox licking up grass. But the oracle or the prophet refers to something even more dangerous. Israel is more than just a wild ox licking up grass. He sees Israel as a horn, a towering horn, a wild ox that cannot be subdued. You are a match for some things, but God has given you power to overcome the power of the enemy. I know the devil has some power, but he does not have all power. There is an ability in you, because greater is you that he that is in you than he that is in the world. Moab also speaks of Israel in the 22nd chapter, and he talks about the threat of Israel. But the oracle, the prophet, says it's more than just the threat of Israel. The power is not with Israel, but the power is with God. And because God has the power, Israel has the power. So Balaam continues on to talk about the affirming definitiveness of God to Israel. God is the Most High in their camp. He also is the one that tells them that in the 23rd chapter, there is no enchantment or witchcraft against God's people. You can't put a spell on a believer, because the spirit is stronger than any spell. That's the unchangeable God that we serve. He breaks down the powers of the enemy and brings them up out of the house of bondage. He tells them this unchangeable, guaranteed is by my blessings. God does not lie. Men lie. We can always find something that's not true, but God changes not, neither is there any turning within him. God is faithful. He guarantees his promise and his promise to his people, to speak to them by the promises that he will make good and fulfill. When God says something, he carries it through. He acts upon his word. God promised something and he guarantees it by a blessing. Let me say that again, and maybe you'll catch it. When God promises something, he guarantees it by a blessing. If you got the blessing, then that's what God has promised. If you ain't got the blessing yet, then the promise has not been fulfilled. But when God promises something, he guarantees it by a blessing. That is the irrevocableness of God. He cannot change. Behold, I am the God of all flesh, and there's nothing too hard for me. God here now sees here the wickedness of Jacob. He said, I don't see it anymore, nor the perverseness, of Israel. The Lord God is with them. A shout of praise is among them. The praise is because there is no more labor. There is no more toil. There's no more troubles. They might be around, but not bothering the people of God. Free from this iniquity and this perverseness, God has lifted that load up off their backs. And he did this through the covenant atonement, and in the Old Testament, and in the New Testament, he did it by the reconciliation of Jesus Christ. Remember, God has promised to bless his people. Therefore, he understands that there will be trials that will come, but the blessing is yet on the way. It's certain according to the word of God. God strengthened his people to be courageous to get through the trial. Let me say that again. Even though the promise is there, remember that God has promised to bless you, and he will strengthen you to get through the trial. Nothing is going to take you but such that is common to man, and God is faithful. Will with the temptation make a way of escape so you can bear it. Are you going with me this morning? Here we go. The conquering power of the believer. God is irrevocable. Irrevocable. He is irrevocable. Irrevocable. He cannot change. He stays the same and consistent. He cannot go back on his word. If he said it, he's going to make it good. God cannot lie. He's not a promise breaker. He's a promise keeper. The integrity of his word, integrity of him is by his word. It's by his character. The word of God is spoken by David. It says God is not for a forger. God speaks it and he does what he said he's going to do. There is no deceit in God. There is no lying in God. There is no going back on the word of God. If God spoke it, it's coming to pass. Here is why the enemy becomes so upset, because he cannot stop what God has spoken, because God's backing it up by the blessing that he said is going to come into your life. God follows you through all of this, and he sees the people of God, and he sees you and I going from place to place and toiling, but not struggling, but that God is giving strength to let us know we're going to get out of this all right, because I don't see any perverseness in Israel. We also learn what the commitment of God is. If God has said it, I told you he's going to do it. If God has spoken it, I told you he's going to bring it to pass. When God begins to speak to us in this latter hour of this year, he's speaking about, I am the God that's going to bring about the blessing. I'm unchanging. I am trusting in the changeless God. In a changing time, it seems like time is running out, but it's just enough time to do what he said he's going to do. When God spoke to Mary over in Luke, the first chapter in verse 45, his angel told her, fear not, for there shall be a performance of the things which was told her of the Lord. When God begins to speak, look for the performance. Look for God to complete what he said and bring about a perfection of the fulfillment of the accomplishment of the events that are evidenced by the promise spoken. I said a mouthful there, but by the evidence of the things that were spoken by the promise of God, look for it to come to pass. When God begins to move, you better get in position. It's going to move real quick, and you're going to move in a hurry, because he's coming by with blessings on top of blessings. The enemy wants to curse and bring about enchantment, but you can't curse what God has blessed. He took a man by Balaam, and every time Balaam opened his mouth, God begins to bless people more. Don't worry about people that don't like you and hating on you. Every time they open their mouth negative, God will bless you even more. The more they talk down, the more higher God will raise you right back up. God is eternal and faithful. He is one that never changed. Can't go back on his word. I'm expecting the great from God. Looking for the miracle promise as he gave to Israel. In spite of what Moab was saying, God still came through and blessed them. He has a whole lot of blessings stored up, a whole lot of blessings to give that's got your name on it. He's the God that changed not, no shadow of turning in him. He always good in his goodness, always great in his greatness, always powerful in his powerfulness, always holy in his holiness. If God's bringing it to pass, there's a sure sign. Somebody don't like it, but God has already said it's going to happen. I got to do what I said I'm going to do. I cannot curse what God has blessed. Let me help you out real quickly. You're blessed in the city. You got it. You're blessed in the field. You're blessed when you're coming. You're blessed when you're going. You're blessed with a mask on. You're blessed sitting at home. No matter where you're at, you are blessed, because you know your God. You know who you serve. You know who's on your side. God is with Israel, and God's with you and me. He never changed. Jesus Christ, he is the same today, yesterday, and forever. I am your God. I am your healer. I am your mediator. I am your helper. I am that I am. Whatever you need me to be, I can be it for you. That's the kind of God I want to serve. I hear a shout, a praise of a king of kings, a lord of lords. There's a praise in your house. A break is breaking out, because God's doing the impossible. He's changing the story. He's a changeless God in a changing time. Men have failed. Government have failed. Can't fix the problem. But God spoke a word to my spirit. He said, Clinton, I'm putting the virus in the atmosphere, but also I'm putting the medicine in the atmosphere. Trees are going to blow healing. Plants are going to blow healing. God said, healing is in the land. Healing is in my hand. Healing is in the wing. That's the God that we serve. Whenever Israel needed another healing, God cut down a tree, threw it in the water. Water be made good. God has everything he need right here on the earth, because he's the changeless God in a changing time. Thank God for his consistency in your life. Give him a praise in that living room. Come on. Open your mouth and give God a praise right there in that house. He's changeless. time cannot contain. He's the same throughout the ages. We are not in a foreign place to God. Maybe in a foreign place to us, but not in a foreign place to God. He's faithful in all of his faithfulness. Tell Balak, God has already blessed them, and you cannot curse them. You cannot put any witchcraft on what God has blessed. It won't work. It won't work. I hear the word of no weapon formed against you shall prosper. It won't work. Pray with me. Father, I thank you now for your grace and your tender mercy that you have sent a word to us today. Now, God, transcend further the airways. Touch the heart of everyone under the sound of my voice. Let them know that you are the changeless God in changing times. Swift they are with transition, but we hold to your hand. Save right now. Heal right now. Strengthen right now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. God bless your hearts.
Amen. What a word. I know you are shouting wherever you're at. If you're in your living room, if you're in your bedroom, wherever you're at, your family room. That was a word. God never changes. It is so sometimes we just need to be reminded.
Yes.
That he's the same. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. He doesn't change. God's not surprised about what's going on.
Not at all.
You know, he's been there, done that before. He's like, you know, trust me. I love it. Love the word. I know you've been encouraged.
Changeless God.
Changeless
God. Changeless God. In changing times. Bring your mind back in and lay hold to that word.
My God.
And believe that God has said it. He will make it good.
Yes,
and there will be a performance. You're not saved, get saved. You want to sow in the kingdom, sow and be blessed.
Yes.
Let the Lord become the strength of your life. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. It's my prayer.
Yes.
We'll see you real soon.
See you soon.